Thomas.
And you mentioned there like the gay themes, homoerotic things, but I think
homoerotic themes.
I don't know. Yeah. Oh. They were surprised themselves that a cucumber might be a phallic symbol, but they are there, the gay undertones. But I think they all have girlfriends, or they're at least mostly straight. Why do you think they choose to?
Well, I've got a football. It doesn't mean I play with it.
That's true. Yeah.
No, I guess. What the rectum raiders or the X-raiders stand for is a sexual liberty and not having to explain any kind of sexual behavior. And I think that's the next step. I have great appreciation for the gay prides and what these guys fought for in the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s. It's humongous. It's made enormous steps. But right now, I think it's the next best step is that we don't have to explain our sexual behavior. We should be able to love one another.
Should never label.
We should be label-less. That makes it much more easy. There are people in the province who have this image that anybody who's homosexual is like a Gerard Joling. Gerard Joling's fine, but if you don't identify with him, it's, and you have to explain to your parents, like, yeah, well, you know, I like, you have to explain, like, I like guys, but no, I'm not wearing a bow tie and I'm not going to sing Maak Me Gek. These kind of explanations, sexuality doesn't need it. Sexuality comes from the inside, it doesn't need a subculture, it doesn't need explanations. It should just be out there.
Yeah.
And don't need any labels, everybody should just be free. So the rectum raiders are not explaining any kind of sexual behavior. And what I notice about them is they're sexually rather free, which I really encourage. Mm. And I stick behind that opinion.
So my asking about why straight guys act like this is actually a perpetuation of stereotype.
Well, why do you think they're straight guys? Yeah, that's
yeah, exactly. It's a perpetuation of stereotype. Well,
terrible.
I've been
like if anybody, like, I always tend to use these straight stereotypes. Like when anybody is talking about football international, I like to joke like, well, that's so straight of yours to talk about football international,
right,
and to
yeah.
watch football. I mean, it's bizarre to think in stereotypes in regard to sexuality. It's the first thing we should lose in this society.
Is it that the world is just not ready for this message?
Well, we're the first ones to take the message.
Right.
Fuck yeah.
Is there anyone in the audience that has a question for Dennis?